हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द पोल साइंस ऑफ क्लास 12 आर्ट्स एंड टुडे वी विल प्रोसीड डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर्स रिलेटेड टू दीनदयाल उपाध्याय. सो लेट अस प्रोसीड देन. सो पंडित दीनदयाल उपाध्याय वॉज अ फिलोसोफर, सोशियोलॉजिस्ट, इकोनॉमिस्ट एंड पॉलिटिशियन. एक्सप्लेन. सो दिस इज a question regarding the life of Deendayal Upadhyay, who was called as a philosopher, sociologist also, economist also, and as a politician also. So regard to this question, we have to explain, we have to touch how he was a philosopher, he was a sociologist, along with that he was an economist and politician also. So let us try to understand the answer then. Pandit Deendayal Upadhyay was a philosopher, sociologist, economist and politician. The philosophy presented by him is called integral humanism. So why he was known as a philosopher, sociologist, economist as well as politician? Because the philosophy presented by him was called integral humanism, in which he was intended to present an indigenous socio-economic model in which human being remains at the center of development. So he himself propounded a theory in his philosophy which was known as integral humanism, and based on integral humanism he wanted to present an indigenous socio-economic model, and under this socio-economic model he wanted human to be the center around the development. That means he wanted humans always to be the center point of the center where development starts, or he wanted to human be at the center of development. The aim of integral humanism is to ensure dignified life for every human being while balancing the needs of individual and society. And at the same time, through his philosophy which is known as integral humanism, the aim of integral humanism was what? To ensure dignified life for every human being. He wanted that through the integral humanism a dignified life should be there for every human being, and that dignified life should be there, but during that time balancing the needs of individual and society must also be included at the same time while ensuring the dignified life of every individual. It supports sustainable consumption of the natural resources so that those resources can be replenished. Along with that, it supports sustainable consumption of natural resources. That means sustainability should be there while consuming the natural resources so that those resources can be replenished, that can be used for the longer run. So integral humanism enhances not only political but also economic and social democracy and freedom. As it seeks to promote diversity, it is the best suited for a country as diverse as India. So regarding integral humanism, which gives humans the center of attraction while the development process is going on, along with that it also ensures the individual or the human being to lead a sustainable life, and along with that integral humanism enhances not only political sphere of the society but it also ensures economic, social democracy and freedom. As it seeks to promote diversity, it is best suited for a country as diverse as India. So in terms of integral humanism, it is assumed that this integral humanism is best suited for a country like India, because the main aim of integral humanism is to promote diversity. Now the philosophy of integral humanism is based on the following three principles. So whatever the aims we have discussed, after that comes the philosophy. What does the philosophy of integral humanism is based on? So the philosophy of integral humanism is based on the following three principles, namely, number one is primacy of whole, not part. Then comes supremacy of dharma. And next comes autonomy of society. So based on these only, These three principles the philosophy of integral humanism is based. First one is the primacy of whole, not part. Then comes supremacy of dharma, and third comes autonomy of society. So Pandit Dindal Upadhyay opposed both Western capitalist individualism and Marxist socialism. So according to Dindal Upadhyay, he was not in favor of Western capitalist individualism also. Clear? Western capitalist individualism also and Marxist socialism also. He was not in favor of both this theory. According to Dindal Upadhyay, capitalist and socialist ideologies only consider the needs of human body and mind, so they are based on materialistic purpose, whereas spiritual development is equally considered important for the complete development of human being, which is missing in both capitalism and socialism. So based on his policy on the internal conscience, pure human soul to be called chitti, Dindayal Upadhyay envisaged a classless, casteless and conflict-free social system in Indian society. So why was he not in favor of Western capitalist individualism and Marxist socialism? Because according to him, whatever the capitalist and socialist ideologies are there, it only considers the needs of human body and mind. So they are based on materialistic purpose. So according to Dindayal Upadhyay, it only considers whatever the capitalist and socialist ideologies are there, it only considers the needs of human body and mind. So he thought that these are based on materialistic purpose, whereas spiritual development is equally considered important for complete development of human being, which is missing in both capitalism and socialism. So according to him, the socialism theory and the capitalism theory only fulfills the needs of human body and mind, but it cannot fulfill the spiritual development. According to Dindayal Upadhyay, he thinks that this spiritual development is very much necessary for the overall development of the human being. So basing his philosophy on the internal conscience, pure human soul to be called chitti, Dindayal Upadhyay envisaged a classless human soul to be called chitti. He wanted a society to be classless, casteless and conflict-free social system. Clear? So he wanted where there should be a classless society, there should be a casteless society, and there also should be conflict-free society where individual can live happily in any society. So he was in favor of these three types of society, and based on his philosophy of integral humanism, it was based on three principles, namely the primacy of whole, then supremacy of dharma and autonomy society. So with this I will wind up today's topic based on the discussions related to Pandit Dindayal Upadhyay and his theory of integral humanism. In the next class we will discuss about the questions related to democratic upsurge in Indian politics. So please make a note down of all these questions and answers in your copy. Thank you.